Hey, what's up, everyone? It's Derek with Nerd or Die, and I'd like to introduce you to our Glitch Premium Alert Package. The new item contains 5 unique designs that will work for Twitch, YouTube, and Mixer. Also, you'll be able to customize the color of both the text and the animation as well, meaning you can create a color scheme that matches your channel. Now, this is all done with custom controls within StreamLabs, making it easy to set up and customize. It'll also allow you to use it with almost any language as well. This is by far one of my favorite alert packages yet, so I hope that everyone enjoys it. Let's get right into it. To get started, head over to nerdordie.com and head to our shop and purchase and download this item. Once you have the project files extracted onto your computer, go ahead and open up the README. The README has detailed instructions and images that will help you get the alert set up inside of your account and also contains customization information. Let's first get the alert set up in our account, then I'll show you how to customize the alerts. First, log into your StreamLabs account if you need to, then go ahead and click the quick setup link in either the README or from the downloaded files. Click create profile towards the bottom and give your profile a name and hit create. Next, to import all the settings, hit use on your newly created profile. Now let's go ahead and add this into OBS Studio. Make sure you're on the alert box tab in StreamLabs and then find your widget URL. In OBS, add in a browser source, then paste your widget URL. Change the height and width to at least 800 each. I personally like to have my width be 1920, which is the width that I stream at, in case I get some longer names in my alerts. Once that's finished, you can run a few tests to make sure things are working properly. You'll notice that the alerts are defaulted to white animations and white text. So let's edit the colors, and we can do that by choosing the type of alert that we'd like to edit. For this example, I'll do my Twitch subscriptions. This process works the same for each type of alert. First, it's important to note that you will not use the message template box like you would for normal alerts. However, sounds and text-to-speech controls will work normally. Scroll down until you see the Custom Fields tab and click on that. This tab contains controls to customize your alerts. Now, the top text area will represent what message is contained in the top part of the alert. It's important to know that both text boxes are compatible with dynamic template tags, so if you'd like to change things up a bit from the wording that we've used by default, you can use template tags such as amount, months, and count in curly braces directly inside these boxes, just like you would with the message template area above. The next two options are the colors for each of your text color. You can use the color pickers or type in a hex code for the colors that you'd like to use here. And then finally, we have animation hue, saturation, and brightness. For this section, I'm going to have the README opened on the left side of my screen and then StreamLabs custom controls on the right. When you scroll down a bit in the README, you'll find controls to preview your alert. Most importantly, you'll find sliders that let you change the hue, saturation, and brightness. Let's start with the hue, which basically will rotate the color of the background animation. Adjust this slider until you get a color that's close to the color of what you're looking for. Next, use the saturation slider to make the color more vibrant or more dull. By default, the 100 value is pretty saturated already, so going up won't change much with the main color. Finally, change the brightness slider where higher will be a color that's lighter and lower will make it darker. If you're looking to get a completely black background, then you can slide this all the way down to 0. For white, you'll want it to be all the way up with the saturation all the way down. If you'd like, you can also change the color of the text here as well to preview all the changes completely. Once you're done picking your color combo, go ahead and copy these values into the custom fields found in StreamLabs. Basically, just match the slider values and you'll be good to go. Once you're done, hit save changes and then preview your alert. Now that we've changed the subalert, I want to point out that we've included a variation for the subalert as well. This will allow you to use different text contained for resubs. Let's click the alert variations box here towards the bottom and then hit edit for our alert that shows when we have a sub for at least 2 months. Again, sounds and text-to-speech will work as normal, and we can scroll down to find the custom fields tab. you'll see that the top text contains the months of the sub rather than new subscriber. Change these boxes and colors to whatever you'd like and refer to your README preview if you need to. Once you're done, hit save and then save settings, and you can preview your alert by clicking test. Now that we've covered changing one alert, you can repeat this process for each type of alert. You can make everything the same colors or even change individual alerts to have their own unique color sets. You'll also be able to quickly and easily change your alerts for things like holidays and events. And if you've enjoyed this video, please make sure to give it a like and share it with anyone that you think would be interested in this alert package. Make sure to subscribe with notifications on because we have some really cool new items coming very soon. If you have any questions at all, please make sure to put them in the comments below. And thanks for watching.